Y'all, hello. I am here. I'm here in New Orleans. Just made it, landed about like 10:45. Got to the hotel. What time is it? It's 12 o'clock now. So checked in. The room was ready. So because one of my girlfriends had COVID that I explained in another vlog, we were supposed to come early September, like the first week of September, but we had to change it to the end of September because of that, right? So there was a whole thing like with the rooms and it was just a lot of logistics to get things and rebooked and everything. And shout out to my girlfriend Kat for doing that for us, since she was the one that originally had booked it. So I will be sleeping on the couch. The couch, it's like a pull-out bed, which I volunteered to do that because like I said, it was just a mess, like getting things reorganized and getting another hotel room booked. And the hotel, honestly, they didn't even want to give us back the deposit, which was a bummer. So we kind of like, it left us with no choice but to book with them again. So we're here, but the hotel is absolutely, absolutely gorgeous. So I'm not even mad that we're staying here. And, you know, things worked out the way that that they were supposed to. So it's all good. So I'm gonna give you guys just a quick tour of the room. I mean, it is absolutely, the architecture, whoever designed this hotel, the interior design, everything, it is just a freaking one. I am loving it. Like, I do not even mind sleeping on this couch because it is cute. I'm about to show it to you in a second. So yeah, y'all, let's get into it. So this is when you first come in. It's like a little living room area. You got the flat screen TV right here. So here's the pull out bed. So it's like a, I want to say that's like a queen size, like whenever it would be pulled out. If not queen size, I'm definitely full. So definitely enough room for me. This cute little chair that I wish I could know where it's from, because I would love to put it in my house. One of the living rooms that I have, I want it to be like a pink and brown interior, so that would be perfect. And then we're coming in here. It's a little coffee area, a couple books up there, a couple waters, coffee. Like I said, this is probably the fridge. Yes, fridge is down here. Wait till y'all see this bathroom. It is so cute. It's not big, but it's enough, y'all. It is enough. So I just think everything, like, look at these appliances, just freaking A1. Everything is clean, immaculate. Got the soaps. I love this shower curtain. It has like New Orleans theme on it. And then if you go behind here is the toilet. So it's a little private space for the toilet, you know, for you to do the do. I mean, it is just absolutely adorable. Like I said, small, but so cute. Here's some bathrobes and TV, another TV. So this is where Kat and Pooja will be sleeping. I mean, look at this. It's a little mini suite. It is just so cute. Like, I am just loving it. The velvet. Yeah, y'all. So anyway, I am just gonna chill until they get here. I think Pooja, her flight arrives around 5. We have dinner reservations at 8. At I think Jack Rose And then from there, we're gonna go to the Spotted Cat, which is a jazz place. So I hope you guys enjoy this vlog. Welcome, welcome, welcome. If you don't know already, my name is Ashley and I specialize in fashion, beauty, lifestyle, and travel. So sorry guys for me stumbling over my words. I'm still getting used to this, to be quite honest, of talking to, you know, technically like a camera, even though I know you guys are on the other end, but it's definitely an adjustment for me. So as I do it more, you know, I'm gonna get better, hopefully. You know, it's all about honing your craft and yeah, just being better at what you want to do. So as time goes on, hopefully I won't stammer as much and stutter as much, and it'll be much more like flowing. So I just appreciate your guys' patience. It is a lot for me actually to get on camera as well, because I'm in the middle of trying to lose weight. I am losing weight. And so I've just been very self-conscious about my body and where I want to be in life as far as like health-wise. So for me to get on camera, like, it's a lot, and I appreciate like all of the nice comments, and I'm glad that nobody has attacked me yet, because you just know how social media can be, child. Like, you just never know. People can be very rude. So I just appreciate, you know, all the love, whether it's a like, a watch, a follow, a comment, you name it. So thanks, guys. But I will talk to you guys a little later. Bye.
Something banana. Banana. I don't taste nothing banana in
it. It's banana in there. That's the mezcal in there.
It's a dish.
Mm-hmm. It's a banana. It's a banana in there. That is really good. Mm-hmm. That's like...
So they just brought a pear. What is it? A pear cheese.
It's poached. Something poached.
Poached something, but it looks good.
Yes.
And they said it's a little surprise, so I don't know if they did this for everybody or if it's
just us.
Right.
If it might just be special.
It's special.
It's special.
Sorry, you're gonna make a phrase in your gumbo, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
What'd you get again?
Halloumi caprese.
And I got the duck and gooey gumbo. So
that looks good.
You can absolutely.
Oh, just me and you?
Like everyone, whatever.
Yeah.
It's been a while.
Of course. I know it has to. February 2018 to be exact.
Damn.
Yes, I know. I'm a plethora of knowledge.
Yeah.
Get on your search bar on your phone, type in Shrek Uber, and watch what pops up.
Oh my goodness. Look at this, y'all. He has Shrek everywhere. Up here, on the outside of the car. He has a green. Shrek friend up front.
And the baby.
And the baby. So check him out on...
Wait. And...
Oh my goodness, and he dresses up for... Is that Comic-Con?
Yep.
He dresses up as Shrek for Comic-Con.
This Saturday I will be dressing up riding Lyft and Uber.
Very nice. Awesome. So guys, check him out like he said on TikTok.
Nola_Shrek_Mobile.
There, you heard it.
The next day.
Hey guys, we are here at Nice Guys, which is a black-owned restaurant in the heart of New Orleans. It isn't really, like, we thought it was going to be more of, like, brunch style. They don't really have too many choices for, like, waffles or French toast and everything, but it is, like, a Creole kind of based restaurant with a lot of Southern cooking and flair, so we're about to get in and dig in. So everything looks good, though.
Thank you. you ready, I'll take your order.
Best friends. I'm gonna just scoop this in the middle, my baby.
Okay.
All right, I'm sorry. I don't mean to be leaning all in your lap.
Okay, that's okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Bon appetit.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome. Wait, hold on. I don't want to go. Wait. Y'all got professional stuff going on. This is a real photo shoot.
Oh, yes. Oh, wait.
I see you.
Not no.
Okay, ready?
Yes.
they know the ratchet pussy juicy. Racks earned.
Morning, everybody. So last night, as you'll see in a couple clips back, was Bourbon Street. When I tell you, it truly is an experience. You don't have to come here on Mardi Gras to get the full experience. I mean, of course, Mardi Gras, as the locals say, it's, you know, the streets are jam-packed. It's definitely more going on. But like last night, as you'll see, like, there was just so much activity. Like, literally, you could bar hop. I don't think any of the bars had a cover charge. There were, you know, people in the streets holding snakes, and you could hold the small ones for $10 or the big ones for $20. What else? There was, you know, musicians, and it was just, it was a vibe, and everybody is so polite here. And I feel like it's, I mean, of course, like in the South, right? Like, it kind of goes without being said that, you know, people are like more polite, but I think sometimes like they're polite, but they don't always mean it. When I tell you people in Louisiana, or at least in New Orleans, like, they genuinely mean it. If they bump into you, and, you know, you pause and you're looking at them, they will literally be like, I am so sorry. Are you okay? Like, they will stop and just make sure that you're okay. Like, even try and chit chat with you or dance a little bit to get you, like, back in, like, a good mood. I mean, it, I'm falling in love with New Orleans, y'all. I really am. excuse me. It has been nothing but good to me. So right now we are about to go to brunch at Commander Palace, which we heard is another like staple to go to. It's supposed to be like a whole experience. It's like a jazz brunch. You actually have to dress up. So I'm in just a plain dress. You know, nothing too fancy or, you know, because it's during the day, but they do require like business casual. So yeah, we're gonna go to that. It is like one of the oldest like restaurants and buildings in New Orleans. So yeah, excited for that experience. And then we're gonna see what the day takes us. We were talking about, you know, going to tours and you know, maybe walking around a little bit and stuff. I know Pooja and I really want to get more of the history of New Orleans, so you know, a tour might be the best. But yeah, you know, come along and you'll see. So cheers.
Choose. John Coltrane or Stevie Wonder.
Yeah.
The same guy, so they play the same style.
You like Stevie Wonder?
Of course. Drink looks good to me, but tequila is just way too strong.
Hold it with your drink.
It is, but for... Oh, yes. You got it.
It's matching.
Holy shit, that's strong.
I have the XL.
His dad likes cooking, so I think his passion just comes from liking to eat food.
Like to eat food, but then also probably like experience like traveling.
And for me, I just like to eat. Yes. I don't like to cook as much.
Sorry, I'm adjusting settings, that's why it's.
It's okay.
He don't know, it might be on tonight.
if they make up on top of it, you can also use it.
Let me know if you have any questions.
Okay.
Contract.